We have been discussing the avenues which we wish to adopt both in this session but also prior to this session. I think we have to understand that war propaganda and media propaganda, mainstream media propaganda, are complicit in the crimes of 9/11. And that means that if we want to disarm this inquisitorial system, which is far worse than the Spanish Inquisition or even the French Inquisition for that matter, we have to address the fabrications of, precisely of, the mainstream media. We're not seeking their support. We are confronting the mainstream media. Without the media, the global war on terrorism would fall flat. It would fall flat. It wouldn't have a leg to stand on. And consequently, the Commission of Inquiry must confront not only politicians and the financiers behind this project, because it, as Mr. Chiesa has pointed out, this is a project of the financial elites. But their legitimacy is based on a propaganda apparatus which is extremely sophisticated and extensive in networking all over the world. And consequently, we have to break that. And it's something which can be broken because it's very fragile. It's extremely, a lie is fragile, okay? Like the Spanish Inquisition is fragile. So what I'm suggesting is the following. Let us proceed with, as I think that's the consensus here, with a commission of inquiry, very selective, very focused. But let us build upon, or let us use this commission of inquiry to interface with other initiatives, to establish an extremely broad network of counter-propaganda. Of counter-propaganda, that is absolutely essential. Because, and it is easier, as we have seen, to break the BBC than it is to break the Pentagon, okay? The BBC is lying. They can be taken to court because war propaganda is a lie. Okay? I'm sorry, war propaganda is a crime. And when the BBC shows Indian flags in Tripoli celebrating the victory of the rebellion with fake images, they are, in fact, committing a war crime. They are complicit in war crimes. So that, essentially, I would suggest commission of inquiry. We have to think very carefully how we want to formulate the legal actions. Scientists who lie are also complicit in war crimes. I think that's clear in Richard Gage's presentation. People who lie in their professional fields, they are complicit in war crimes. Scientists who say that nuclear weapons are harmless to the surrounding civilian population are liars, and they are complicit in war crimes. So consequently, I say, let us proceed and think very carefully the commission of inquiry, but let us also see who we want to target as part of a legal mechanism. And I suggest, let's start by going after the media. I'm not seeking the friendliness with the media or their support. Precisely, we are confronting the media. The media is not covering, won't cover objectively what is happening in this venue. But we have a very powerful networking, also with the internet, where we can go after the media and confront them, politely confront them on the lies which are tantamount to war crimes because they are denying and covering up crimes against humanity as well as conspiracies such as those of 9/11. Thank you.